Okay, so in order to take this apart, we have to take these knobs off. These knobs will come off. They're a little tight sometimes, but they will come off. They're basically all the same, so you don't have to worry about mixing them up. They're basically the same. And once you get these knobs off, and you take these screws out, the screws are basically all the same size except for this one here, and that one, the longest one, goes in right there. Okay, so once you get those screws off and the knobs off, this will simply half in part. It will come apart from the front here, and you'll be able to take it apart. We have screws under the antenna as well, and that, and there's one screw here, and this is the antenna screw. We leave that in place. Okay, and then remember, we have one screw under the quality control sticker, and once you remove this, your warranty is invalid. So once you get that off, then you should be able to take it apart. It's like so. So there it is. And so this speaker is soldered in. And so you have to be careful with that. Just sets in place like so. Put it over there for now. Okay, so we can see that we're supposed to have one of these little idlers, a little round thing, right here, and it holds that string up. So this string here is supposed to be held up.
And just as genetic engineering is designed ultimately to do away with the human,
and there's supposed to be an idler right there, and that idler is broken off. What I have done before, I'll take like a hot paper clip and make a hole in there, and so that I can put another idler. Basically it's this thing here. It's a little pulley that wire rides on. And so you can sort of makeshift your own, or you can see if you can find the other one. The other one's probably hiding back here in the bottom somewhere. I thought I heard it rattling around. And then you can use that to fix that. That's all that's wrong with it. Good quality radio. It has a twin coil ferrite antenna, which tends to pick up stations a little easier than most radios. Okay, so some of these used to have springs in them to keep the tension on the wires. And so you can see what I've done here. I take a hot paper clip and poke a hole in. This is actually part of an old pin. It's just the top part of the old pin, ink pin. This part here is the top part of the ink pin. Got a hot wire, poked a hole here, through there, and also poked a hole through the top part of the pin. So what we'll do is we'll put that right there, and that will serve as the idler or pulley for this over here. And then we can use this paper clip to act as an axle for this. And what I'll probably do is I'll probably leave the paper clip long and glue it to the top and the sides here so that it has plenty of stuff to hold it in place. Okay, you can see what I've done here. We have, this is basically a paper clip in between there, and we ran it all the way through this one. If this were the one, it would go all the way through, and I'm glued the end, and I've also glued it up here so that, you know, this is stable. And then this thing will, this will be the idler here, and that will just be able to guide that string along. Once that'll dry, then I'll tighten it up here, hook these other ones up, and there's one down behind that one too, and hopefully it will work. Now, if you're trying to do this, it might be a good idea to make it so that you can redo it in case you don't have enough tension on it or something didn't work out right. So anyway, but you can see that it's basically working right now. It's not perfect, but it does work. And if this pointer is not moving when you turn the dial, basically it doesn't turn the tuner. The tuner is wrapped around back behind there, and it will not allow you to get any stations. You'll probably just hear air sounds or static. So that's your quick fix for your seat frame. Now it's time to put it all back together.
These pliers, and so you can see what I've done here. I take a hot paper clip and poke a hole in. This is actually part of a part of an old pin. It's just the top part of the old pin. Ink pin. This part here is the top part of the ink pin.
Or jet vapor.